Google has just launched their Gemini 3 model, and this has been regarded as the most powerful model out there in the world. And the stats also prove the same. As you can see here in the benchmark, this is Gemini 3 Pro, and this is Gemini 2.5 Pro, and we are having Claude Sonnet 4.5 and GPT 5.1. Basically, the flagship models of all the big companies. It just single-handedly dominates all the other models in every benchmark. So, to give some highlights, just look at this ARC AGI 2 and Humanities Last Exam. It's almost 50% better than the existing models. And the same applies for ARC AGI 2, almost twice better than the existing models. And another crazy benchmark is this Vending Bench 2, which basically allows AI models to control a vending machine and to take decisions based upon buying and selling and getting profit. And just look at how much money Gemini 3 Pro made compared to the others. The only place where Gemini 3 Pro is on par with Claude is the SWE benchmark, which is at 76%, and Claude Sonnet 4.5 is 77%. Not an insane difference, but apart from that, Gemini 3 Pro just insanely dominates everywhere. And this doesn't stop over here. We are having Gemini 3 Deep Think that's even more crazier than Gemini 3 Pro. In Humanities Last Exam, it takes 41%, Scientific Knowledge 93%, and just look at this ARC AGI 2, it's at 45%. And 3 Pro is just 31%, and just look at other models. And that's just a peak record set by Gemini 3. So in this video, we'll be testing it with a lot of coding prompts. I'm having a bunch. So let's see what it can give us. So to use Gemini 3, there are two ways. Either you can use directly in the Gemini app. Here, as you can see, we're having fast and thinking mode with Gemini 3 Pro. And another case is in Google AI Studio. Here also we can use that model. If you use in Google AI Studio, you can like customize it according to your wish and you can play around with it. So I will just go with the Gemini app itself, and here I'm having the prompt. So first let's test with this prompt. Simulate movement of all the planets around the sun using 3D animation in a single file. Let's see what it gives. So this is the output that we are getting, and damn, that just looks so amazing. Let me just open it in a new tab. And wow, I really like the particles or asteroids that are appearing like stars. And just look at this, okay? This looks so good. Like the particles literally coming up onto a screen. And we can zoom in. So we have the sun and other planets also. It has literally done everything mentioned in the prompt. We got the 3D, we got the planets. And yep. Top notch, and let's move on to the next prompt. So this time I'm going to give it a simple but challenging prompt. Show the side view of the bird flying in one single file. This could be like a simple prompt just to create a bird, but it's using HTML, CSS and JavaScript. And the crazy thing is that I have tested this prompt with multiple models, and only 2 out of 10 models were able to replicate the bird itself. The rest of the times you wouldn't even be able to recognize if it was a bird. That's how the output we got from the other models. Let's see if Gemini 3 can do it perfectly. Okay, this is the code that we have got. Let me just copy it and open it in an HTML viewer. And damn, that looks so good, okay? That's not bad at all, okay? Move your mouse up and down to guide the bird. Okay, that looks quite nice. That's interesting. And I would put it in top 10% of the best results that I got from this prompt, because it actually looks like a bird. It has good beak, good eyes. It has perfect wings. And I really like this extra feature that Gemini has added, like this mouse movement and the background clouds, the sky gradient, everything looks perfect. And damn, this model is already killing it. So next, let's test this. Here I'm having a sample resume, which has basically all the details, name, email, professional summary, technical summary, work experience, and stuff. So now what I'm going to do is, I'm going to send this PDF file over here and ask Gemini 3 to generate a portfolio website. So I'll just go here, upload files, upload this, and I am in the canvas mode going with three thinking, and this is going to be my prompt. This is my resume. Using this, create me the most stylish, amazing and best portfolio website that can ever exist. So I've given a extremely positive prompt, and let's see what Gemini 3 gives for this. We have got the website. I didn't mention what tech stack that it has to use, and it has used React for this. So let me just go to preview, and damn, that looks stunning. Okay, let me just go to a new tab. Damn, that just looks stunning. I really like the gradient. The gradient is perfect. The theme just hits you, right? We are having this light blue, dark blue, and a bit of white color, and a mix of all these three colors. So the theme is so minimalistic and just hits at the right chords. That's how beautiful it is. And it's so clean. And I really like the effects. Yeah, LinkedIn, email, the phone number. Everything just looks so perfect. Like, yeah. Of course, we just gave it a minimalistic prompt and it has delivered it so well. Like, everything has been included over here. Yep, that just looks so good. And another feature that I noted here is that here we are having had Gemini features. I think that's adding the API features. And apart from that, here we are having select and ask. So I can click this and I can just draw a screenshot thing like this. And here it's giving me a prompt saying ask Gemini. I'll just go with, can you change the text here to I am John, something like this. Okay, let's see what happens. And I send it. And damn, it has done it. So this is basically like performing generative fill AI in Photoshop, but for websites. You can simply like screenshot any portion of your website and just ask it to do changes, and it literally does it. So that's totally amazing. So let's move on to the next prompt. Here I am in Twitter, and what I'm going to do is I have just took a screenshot of this page, and now I'm going to input this over here. Just going to put the image over here, and I'm going to ask Gemini to convert this image into a website. I want to exactly replicate all the features and themes in the image and not to change anything. So earlier we tested PDF to a website, and now let's see how it can convert a screenshot into a particular website. Okay. And the reason why I chose Twitter is because it has a lot of, you know, buttons and lot of subcomponents going on over here. So I just want to know how Gemini is going to do that. And we can also add one more prompt here. Make sure all the buttons, clicks and components work here. Mock the data wherever it is needed. So let's see what it gives us. I'm going with the canvas mode. And it just looks totally stunning. Let's see in the full screen view. This is the full screen view, and damn, that just looks stunning. If I put the Twitter interface, okay, this is the real Twitter interface. And this is the one Gemini has replicated from a screenshot. That's absolutely mind-blowing. And here we are having a scroll bar. We don't have a scroll bar here, but that's fine. And here also we are having another scroll bar. Okay, that needs to be fixed. You need to have only one scroll bar. But just look at the details over here. Everything looks stunning. And the clicks are not working, but that's fine. And it has literally replicated the interface. Like, I would say that's almost 99% matching. If you just let aside the scroll bar, that's 100%. So that's insane. I have never seen any AI model replicating a screenshot this perfectly. Okay, that's totally insane, to be honest. Yeah. As a conclusion, what I would say is there has been an amazing improvement from Gemini 2.5 Pro to Gemini 3, and it's clearly visible from the results that we have got. And to be honest, this is one of the best coding models I have ever used. And do let me know in the comments what you think about it. Check the playlist of my channel. Done a lot of videos in programming and AI tools. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.